My name's Samantha. Today I'm going to show you how to treat a dog wound. This is my chocolate lab, Sadie, and I'm going to get close up to her paw in a second to show you up close what you should do. But I just wanted to go through some of the supplies that you might need. Dog hair clippers or scissors to trim some of the hair around the wound. I always recommend wearing latex gloves. You should have those in your first aid kit. That keeps you safe and prevents you from getting more bacteria in the wound. You're going to need gauze pads. Make sure that they're non-stick. This one is also not self-adherent. Some of them have the sticky around the edge where you can adhere it, but you don't want to do that because it's going to stick to their fur. You'll need some antibiotic ointment, some medical tape, or some people use like an ACE bandage you can use to wrap it after you've treated the wound. But I recommend like a vet wrap. ACE bandages are easier for dogs to get off, but the self-sticking vet wrap works really well. You may also need boots or a cone, an Elizabethan collar, an e-collar if the wound is in an area where your dog's gonna lick it or get to it. If it's on the paws, I recommend just putting a boot over it. You may need to wrap it if it's somewhere on your dog's side. Maybe you need to wrap with vet wrap all around to keep him from being able to access the wound. So you're gonna need a way to prevent him from accessing it after you have treated it. The other thing that you're going to need, I don't have it right here, is some antiseptic solution. And you want to get non-stinging. That's going to be to rinse out the wound as well. So that's your list of supplies. You know, depending on the wound, there may be something that you need if it's a little, you know, if it's a strange type of wound or in a different area. But assess the wound, gather your supplies is your first step. So now the first thing that I should mention is that if your dog was attacked by another animal or the wound is really deep and requires, or you think it may require stitches, that's when you need to seek veterinary care. If the wound has been there for multiple days, if there's any chance that it might be infected, you don't want to try to take care of it at home. You want to make sure that you take your dog in for veterinary care so that the problem doesn't get worse. So I've got my gloves on. I'm going to pretend that Sadie's got a wound on her paw. She doesn't, thankfully, but anywhere the wound is, you're gonna go about the same step. So the first thing you'll wanna do, if the wound is bleeding, you're gonna take a clean gauze pad, hold it on, and apply pressure until the bleeding stops. No matter where it is, this is the treatment for bleeding, for a bleeding wound. It should stop within about 10 minutes. If it doesn't stop after 20 minutes, you need to go seek veterinary care immediately. If your dog has a wound, speaking of that, one of the best things to do is to have another person with you, another adult. If you have a neighbor or family member that can come over, if for some reason your dog needs to go to the vet, especially if they're bleeding, someone can sit with the dog and hold pressure on the wound and the other person can drive you there. Once the bleeding has stopped, you can go ahead and start treatment. So the first thing, as I mentioned, you have clippers or scissors. Just, you know, trim the hair around the wound. If it's, you know, you're using clippers, just get in there. Make sure you trim as much of the hair as you can. That's going to help to keep the wound clean and stop any possible infections. So Thor thinks something's wrong with his sister, so he's up here checking it out. Once you have the wound, once you have the hair trimmed around the wound and the bleeding has stopped, you're going to want to rinse the area with clean water and pat it dry with a clean towel or clean cloth. Apply the antiseptic solution. Apply some of the antimicrobial, antibacterial ointment. Neosporin is a common one. You can buy the generic version. It doesn't matter. So apply the ointment, a nice thick layer. Then you're gonna cover, not with the same gauze that you used for the bleeding. You're gonna take another clean gauze pad, cover the area, and then you can wrap it, like I said, with the medical tape. You can wrap it with vet wrap. That's my go-to, that's in our dog first aid kit. Then cover it or do whatever you need to do to prevent your dog from accessing it. So boot it if it's a paw, put a collar on your dog, wrap it, you know, really well if it's somewhere on the back end of your pet so that they can't access it. That's how I treat a dog wound. As I said, you know, there are some times where you need to seek veterinary help. So if you need to do that, don't take that lightly. Seek veterinary care if you think that that is something that your dog needs. If you have any other questions, feel free to email me. Thanks for watching this video guide.